Hi, I'm James.
And I'm Laurent.
And this is Beatty, our little Pomsky.
And today we're going to talk about our favorite topic, dog poop.
Or rather about potty training and teaching your dog how to use a doorbell to let you know when they need to go outside.
I learned to ring the bell, ring the bell.
If you get a puppy at 8 or 10 weeks old, chances are they won't be potty trained. And potty training is one of the first things you'll have to teach your puppy.
You want them to know that peeing and pooping are things they need to do outside the house and not inside the house.
There are already lots of great videos on YouTube, and we won't cover potty training in this video.
This video is about teaching your dog how to let you know when they need to go outside.
And one of the best ways to do that is to teach your puppy how to ring a doorbell.
In our house, we have two bells, one on the front door and one on the back door.
When Beatty needs to go outside, she just rings one of the bells and we know it's time to go.
It's such a great trick. We wish we had used them with Maya, our previous dog.
Of course, it didn't come naturally, and it was a little bit of work to get to where we are today.
But it's really not that hard if you go about it the right way.
So what you want to do is have your puppy make the connection between these four things.
If I ring the bell, I'll receive praise, I'll get a treat, and I'll get to go outside.
You want your dog to know that every time they ring the bell, they will get these three things that they like. Get a praise, get a treat, and go outside.
The most important thing is to never break the link between these four elements. Because what's happening is that for you, the link you really care about is the link between the bell and going outside.
And you want your puppy to eventually get there, but initially, it will be a lot easier for your puppy to make the link between the bell and the treats.
So where do we start?
Well, the first step is to install a bell on the door.
What we use is just a couple of jingle bells at the end of a string that's hanging from the doorknob.
Very homemade solution.
When we first started, we tried with a bell we bought from a pet store. We put the button right next to the door and the actual bell plugged into an electric outlet.
But we had zero success with that.
Beatty just never made the connection between the button to press right next to the door, the bell ringing elsewhere on the electrical outlet, the treats, and then going outside. She was just too confused.
What happened is that the bell was adding a fifth step to the process, and it made things more complicated.
And we don't like complicated. We prefer easy.
The link was, if I press the button here, a sound is going to come from somewhere else. I will get a praise. I will get a treat. I will get to go outside.
That was five steps instead of four, and that's a lot to process for an eight-week-old puppy.
We rung the bell for her, we tried to show her how it worked using her paw, using her nose, and it never worked out, and we really got discouraged.
But the minute we switched to a physical bell, she got it within 24 hours.
I guess it was easier for her to see the bell and the noise coming from the bell.
We're sure some people have had success with these electronic bells from the pet store, but for us, the jingle bells were the easiest way to go.
Once you've installed the bell on the door, the next step is to bring your puppy in front of the door.
The first connection you want to create for your puppy is, if I ring the bell, I'll get a treat.
We know that as owners, you don't really care about the treats. You care about the connection between the bell and going outside, but you have to take things slowly.
Remember, your puppy is only 8 weeks old, and you have to put yourself in their little puppy shoes.
Now that your puppy is in front of the door, these are the steps you want to follow. You ring the bell.
And it's important your dog sees you ring the bell.
You give them a big treat. You open the door and you send your puppy outside.
Even at 8 weeks old, it shouldn't take very long for your puppy's brain to make the connection between ringing the bell and getting a treat.
Pavlov demonstrated that more than 100 years ago.
Very quickly, your puppy will have figured it out and they'll ring the bell on their own.
And it's super important that you're ready when your puppy rings the bell.
The last thing you want is to see your puppy ring the bell for the very first time and you don't have any treats.
I always have treats in my pocket, just in case.
But when Beatty was a puppy, we had treats all over the house, in the kitchen, in the living room, wherever we were likely to train her for something.
The best is to have a bag of treats right next to the door, because the first time your puppy rings the bell, you want to make a big deal out of it.
No restraint on the praise and no restraint on the treat.
So your puppy has now made the connection between the doorbells and the treats, and you want to reinforce that connection every time they ring the bell.
But you want to move from bell equals treat to bell equals going outside. The treat is just the intermediary step.
But you can't make the move too quickly. So initially, it's super important to always reinforce these four steps. Ring the bell equals praise equals treat equals going outside.
Dogs are creatures of habit, and dog training requires repetition and consistency.
You want to repeat these four steps over and over again until your puppy completely gets it and associates the bell with going outside, not just the treats. And there's been more and more of you watching our videos, so we're super thankful that you're enjoying our channel.
And tell us where you're from in the comments below.
Tell us your state or your country, we'd love to know.
Something we see a lot are dog owners saying, now that my puppy has discovered this new trick, he rings the bell 25 times a day, how do I know whether my puppy really needs to go outside or whether he just wants a treat?
And the answer is, you don't know, unfortunately. Even a puppy bladder doesn't need relieving 25 times a day, and you know your puppy is probably messing with you.
This thing is great. I just ring the bell and I get a treat.
But you have to stick with it. And again, the most important thing is to not break the link between the four elements. Ring the bell, get a praise, get a treat, and get to go outside.
If you think your puppy doesn't really need to go outside and is just ringing the bell because he wants a treat, you still have to praise him for ringing the bell, and you still have to give him a treat, and you still have to send him outside.
And that's where the trick is. If your puppy is only interested in the treat and not really interested in going outside, you have to force him to go outside. Your puppy has to understand that if he rings the bell, he's not just getting a treat, he also has to go outside.
Whether he likes it or not. And if you suspect your puppy didn't really need to go outside, you have to leave him outside for a few minutes and not let him in right away. At some point, going outside won't be as much fun anymore.
And your puppy will stop ringing the bell if he doesn't need to go outside, because the cost of going outside if he doesn't have to will outweigh the benefit of getting a treat.
At some point, you'll have to start removing the treats from the equation so that the link between the bell and going outside becomes the strongest link.
But you don't want to do this too quickly. Puppy training is never linear. Someday you'll think you're making good progress, and then the next day you're like, things are going backwards.
Instead of eliminating the treats cold turkey, you have to progressively make the treats become a smaller part of the process.
One way to do this is to use treats that you can easily break into smaller pieces and start giving your puppy a smaller treat every time.
You don't think I know you're only giving me half a treat? Really, Daddy?
Another way is to switch to a lower value treat. When you start bell training, you have to use your puppy's favorite treat in the whole wide world.
But once your puppy gets the hang of it, you can progressively use less valuable treats before you get rid of the treats altogether.
So how do you know which treats are your puppy's favorite?
One easy way to find out is to put three different types of treats on the floor and see in which order your puppy eats them. Your puppy will always start with their favorite treat and then work their way down the list.
We just ran a little experiment where we put three treats on the floor. One was Red Barn's Lemlung training treat, one was a generic training treat, and one was a piece of sweet potato.
And that's exactly the order that Beattie followed. Red Barn was clearly her favorite.
And Red Barn is the sponsor of this video, by the way. We'll put a link to their website in the video description below.
As Beattie understood better and better the link between ringing the bell and going outside, we progressively gave her smaller treats and lower value treats.
And now she just rings the bell when she wants to go outside. There are no more treats involved.
And when she rings the bell, she expects us to open the door right away.
If there's something outside she's really interested in, and we don't open the door fast enough, she'll just slam the bell a second time.
What part of "I just rang the bell" don't you understand, Daddy?
But that's a small price to pay, because training her to let us know when she needs to go outside has been a game changer.
It really has. As you saw in this video, we live in a house with a backyard.
So it's easy for us to let Beattie out in the yard when she rings the bell.
When we were teaching her as a puppy, if she rang the bell 25 times, it was easy for us to let her outside 25 times if needed.
If you live in an apartment and need to go down three flights of stairs every time you go outside, it makes things a little bit more cumbersome.
But the basics are still the same, and it's really not that hard, and it's so worth it. So we hope you enjoyed this video. If you did,
give it a big thumbs up.
And put your comments
in the comment section below.
And if you want to subscribe to our channel,
we're going
to
put a link right here.
And if you want to watch our other Pomsky videos, we're going to put one right here and another one right there. Bye.
Beattie says bye.
Bye.